All right, Mr. D, let's talk about those stink bugs, right? Because they do stink, right?
Stinking stink bugs, that's right. They do stink.
They do stink.
And that is a predator avoidance mechanism that they have. And they consider me and you predators. And so when we mess with them, they will stink to try to get us to leave them alone. And birds and other critters that feed on them might not feed on them if they smell bad. They probably taste bad too. I've never tasted them, even though they are eaten in some countries around the world.
Oh, really?
Humans actually eat stink bugs in some countries around the world. Check it out.
I think I will take that out.
I can't imagine it. They're already flavored. You don't have to add any flavors to them, I guess.
All right.
But they are a major pest. Okay. Stink bugs feed on just about everything that you and I feed on, anything that's good. And they're not leaf, they don't have chewing mouth parts. They're not leaf feeders. It's not as easy to see the damage at first when they first attack, because they have piercing, sucking mouth parts. And they will stick their proboscis into fruit or beans or peas or tomatoes or pecans or anything that has juice and protein and things like that, and they will feed on it. And any time they do that, if it's real small, it destroys if it's a cowpea that they're feeding on, or southern pea or something like that, then the pea that they're feeding on is not any good for consumption. With larger fruit like apples and pears and pecans to some extent, if they just feed one time, then you've just got a dark spot, a discolored spot in the fruit, or that you can still.
And that's usually what you see on the kernel of the pecan, right? The little dark spots.
Well, you'll see it. Correct. Right. After you've cracked the pecan open and the kernel, there'll be a little bitty spot on the. And sometimes there'll be three or four, which, if I'm a stink bug and it tasted good there, I may scoot over and do another. And they will feed. They can't feed on that pecan when the shell is hard. So they're feeding on the pecan when the shell is soft.
Okay, good point.
It's relatively immature.
Okay.
But all stages of the stink bugs undergo incomplete metamorphosis or gradual metamorphosis. Egg, the nymph, and then the adult. And so the nymph also feeds on things just like the adult does with the piercing and sucking mouth part. But adults are there are several kinds of them that are green stink bug is probably the most common, and there are brown stink bugs. There's stink bugs that have imported into the country, a brown marmotted stink bug that's out there. But the most common is the green stink bug. The adults are strong flyers, so you can wipe out every stink bug in your garden and you can have a whole another flock come flying in there. They are especially a problem if you live close to agricultural fields and they may be out there in the field and the farmer comes in and harvests the fields and they just they have no other place to go, so they're out looking for something to eat, and they're trying to build up some reserves to they go into the winter, and they'll overwinter as adults, and inside buildings, under logs, in residue and things like that. They need a place they can find some protection, and then in the springtime the adults will come out and lay eggs and start the whole process over again. Several generations a year of the green stink bug, and the common ones around here, they can have 4 to 5 generations a year. Female lays egg masses. You can see the egg masses from 20 to 100 little barrel-shaped eggs in a cluster. And if you see that, get rid of it quickly, because they'll hatch out. The nymphs stick together for a little while, and then as they go through several instars, they will spread out and start acting more like an adult. And then as soon as they sprout their wings, they're ready to go.
Yeah. Are they a huge problem in agronomic crops?
They are a big problem in agronomic crops. I was at a field day just the other day, and the entomologist was out with a sweep net taking sweeps, and I think the economic threshold is 12 stink bugs per 100 sweeps of a net, and it's very easy to get that many. And so, you know, just a few can cause a problem in cotton. They mess up cotton bowls. And so far, with all of the genetic engineering that we've had out there, like the BTs and things like that, nothing, we've developed nothing that will kill stink bugs. Most of the stink bugs are susceptible to most of the pesticides, synthetic pyrethrins, pyrethroids, and also the, but the brown stink bug, the pyrethroids do not do as good a job. They are somewhat, you know, they can tolerate the pyrethrins, and they have to go back for the organophosphates like acephate or something like that. But they're just tough to control. I looked in our red book on how to control them, and it's kind of interesting. Had the same only a couple of things were listed to control them. For example, under beans. Gamma sahalathrin and spinosad were two things that were listed for beans, and then as I looked on down through there, when I got to southern peas, the same two products were listed. So it's the same thing for beans and peas, or gamma sahalathrin and spinosad. But then on some of the others, on broccoli, for instance, it lists carbaryl, bifenthrin, and zeta sapermethrin. So three products were listed for broccoli. So it depends on what you've got, what crop you've got, and you don't normally think of stink bugs as being a pest of broccoli.
No, you sure don't.
But they are. And this again is out of the red book. Okra.
Oh gosh.
It's got carbaryl and cyfluthrin. So you know carbaryl is, you know, 7, carbamate. So these are two different classes of chemistry here, carbaryl normally is considered for insects with chewing mouth parts,
right?
For the most part, but that's kind of interesting.
Mouth part. Okay.
But then I flipped over to tomato, and
tomatoes,
you have a few more tools in their arsenal that you can use for tomatoes: the carbaryl, cyfluthrin, permethrin, esfenvalerate, bifenthrin, and zeta sapermethrin. So pretty much everything that's listed on the others, you can use all of them for tomatoes to control. Stink bugs. Mm-hmm. But I guess the take-home point from that is to make sure that you know what crop you're going to use it on. You can't just, but there is probably one of those that I mentioned that you could spray on all of those.
What about fruit trees, quickly?
What about fruit trees? Yeah. Your home orchard spray guy should take care of that. Unfortunately, stink bugs are like a few other insect pests out there. There are not many IPM things that we can do. And IPM, of course, integrated pest management. Not too many organic things out there that I'm aware of, other than old standby, the two bricks. You know, you smack them real hard, you're going to get the smell. The smell's going to be there, and you got to watch your thumbs.
Watch your thumbs, right?
You can mash your thumbs if you're not careful. But if you do the two brick, you are going to have to deal with the smell.
Yes, you are. And that's your organic means to control the stink bugs.
That is an organic means to control.
Wow. All right, Mr. D.
It's not a good pest to have.
Not a good pest to have. Right. Stink bugs do stink, y'all.
Stinking stink bugs.
All right, thanks, Mr. D. That was good.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.